Hi, I'm Dr. Lisa Thompson of drlisamthompson.com, and in today's video, we're going to go over Facebook Messenger marketing do's and don'ts so that you can stay in Facebook good's graces and really build that relationship with your list so that you can get more sales using Facebook Messenger marketing. Now, keep this in mind. The key to good Facebook Messenger marketing is you need to build an audience and engage your audience before you sell to your audience. If you keep that framework in the back of your head, this is really going to help you. So let's look at the Facebook Messenger marketing do's and don'ts. The first is always be respectful of personal space. So when you're interacting with people on Facebook, you want to treat them as if they are sitting directly across from you. When you're having a conversation, you don't want to be so in their face. You want to be, the purpose of doing this is not to sell them on the first interaction. You want to seek conversations over conversions. That is very, very important. Second tip, never send a link unless you ask first. Okay, because if you're sending unsolicited links, what's going to happen is people are not going to like it. They're going to report it to Facebook that it's spam. You can either land in jail or you're going to get your account suspended. So you always want to ask for permission. Embrace permission-based marketing. So when you're doing that, you can say, hey, I have a great training that will help you with whatever that problem is, or you could say, I have a great newsletter that can help you with your permission, may I send you the link? If not, no big deal. So when you're doing this, you want to ask permission to send the link first and see if they're open to it, and then give them an out, because that's going to make people feel like they have a choice. And a lot of times when you give them that choice, they're going to be more than interested and open to being on your list or receiving that training. The other thing you want to do is keeping things conversational 95% of the time. When people are using Facebook Messenger, most people, when they use it, they're communicating, they're talking. They're engaging with their friends. They're not using it as a way of selling, okay? So you want to keep things conversational, because there will come a point when you build that know, like, and trust factor enough where people are going to, they're going to buy from you or join your team because of your recommendation. So you want to be focusing on them, what problems they need solved, and help provide solutions. If you're doing mass messaging, now there's a way you can do that on Facebook Messenger marketing. We're not going to cover it here. But if you do mass messages, do it only once per week. You don't want to be doing it because that is considered like with bulk email. And if you do that, it is considered spammy. People do not like being grouped into emails, because especially on, and even on Facebook messengers, you know, that's something that I don't really appreciate, is when I get lumped into a group of people and they're doing a message which I don't want to be a part of, and that can be really annoying as well. But if you are going to be doing mass messages, or you're going to communicate to a group of people, always make sure to ask ahead of time if they want to be part of a group message, because that way you're, again, you're being respectful. Be respectful of their personal space. If you overdo with messages, it can lead to less opens and effectiveness over time. So you want to make sure when you are using Facebook Messenger marketing that you're doing it in a way that people are going to want to stay in the loop. If you do it too many times, people can get really annoyed with it. Now, make sure you stay tuned for tomorrow's video, because I'm gonna walk you through how to set up your Facebook auto reply feature. This is a real simple way. On your fan page, there's a way you can start this whole Messenger marketing process. Now, to get that video, if you haven't done so already, make sure you have liked my fan page by going to facebook.com/Dr. Lisa Thompson. Like my page and make sure you've clicked the follow button. That way you'll be notified when the video goes live. Now, there's two ways you can watch the video on my Facebook fan page. You can see it on the main wall here, or you can follow it from my YouTube channel without leaving Facebook. So to do that, all you have to do is when you go to facebook.com/Dr. Lisa Thompson on my fan page, look over here on the left-hand side of your screen, look for the tab that says Dr. Lisa's YouTube videos. You will see the featured video right up here on the featured screen setting. And then make sure you click subscribe to my YouTube channel as well. Now, if you really want to dive into Facebook Messenger marketing and really understand the nuances of how to do it, my good friend and Facebook Messenger marketing expert Antonio Thompson is doing a free masterclass where he's really going to break this down into detail to show you how to get leads with Facebook Messenger marketing, how to qualify those leads so you can carry on the conversation, and how to use Facebook Messenger marketing to close these leads to become reps and customers in your business, and doing it in less than 30 minutes a day. So if you're someone who is super, super busy and you don't have a lot of time to devote to your business, doing Facebook Messenger marketing is really going to be a time saver for you. To register for this training, all you need to do is register where you see the registration link at the bottom of your screen here. I've also put the registration link in the video description and in the comments section. So all you have to do is register and then make sure you show up 15 to 30 minutes early to assure your spot, because this is going to sell out. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.